Good morning, everyone. Myself, Dr. Manju Singhania. We will be continuing under HRM, Semester 6, TY BCom. The topic today of discussion is human resource development. Now, what is the first we will, what you will learn from this lecture? What is the concept of human resource development? Then, what are the functions of the human resource development? As in the image you are observing, that learning is there. Yes, development means, development is what? Growth. And how the growth of the organization will take place. For that reason, human resource development is there. Human resource development refers to an assortment of training program to whom the training will be provided, what training will be provided, which will help the people to adjust their new role. As you know that business is dynamic. And as the business is changing, employees also have to change. And their role also changes. So they have to adjust their new roles and learn more about the organization and its culture. A protocol for HRD teaches employees a skill may development of the skills of the employee, which they may need for their jobs, and grants them success, access to the resources of the organization, which can help them to get success. It refers to the training that organization provides. Organization provides training, learning for what? Learning is provided to improve the knowledge, skill, abilities, attitude, and their behavior so that they can work effectively. Their development will take place. Organization's development can also take place because they will give the performance, and business is a group activity. So human resource development refers to the training that organization provide to their employee so that they can develop the skill which is needed to be successful. Human resource development can also be defined as the increasing knowledge, capabilities, and positive work attitude. Now, when we talk about what is the meaning of knowledge, that also you must understand. Knowledge is gaining information. And whatsoever information, drastic changes are happening in the information. Skills which we have learned, or individuals have learned, in that skill also changes takes place. Various theories are there which comes out, new theories are developed, research activity takes place. So employees' knowledge need to be updated. Existing knowledge may become obsolete, may become outdated. With that knowledge, it becomes difficult for employees to get the adaptability to the changing environment. So it is necessary to update the knowledge of the employee, and for the updation of the knowledge, yes, what learning is provided, that comes under the human resource development skill. What do you understand by skill? Suppose, for example, you have a restaurant. In the restaurant, you employ cook. And food demand changes. Sometimes there is a If I talk about the yes food demand, sometimes Chinese is in demand, sometimes fusion of the Indo-Chinese is required, and all that yes skill of the employee need to be updated. He must be trained, he or she must be trained to learn new ways, and that is called as the updating the skill of the employee. Knowledge, skill, attitude. What is attitude? Self-respect is very essential. Self-respect is the positive attitude. But the same self-respect, when you start considering only yourself superior and you start considering other as inferior, Swabhiman is required by everyone. Everyone must have the self-respect. But you consider yourself only as superior and you start considering others as inferior, then that is called as a negative attitude. And when you have negative attitude, the work environment of the organization is suffered. And entire organization suffers because of the wrong attitude. So every employee, each and every member of the organization must have the positive attitude. Swabhiman should be there, but Swabhiman should not be Abhiman. That is the having developing the positive attitude among the employee. So it is the increasing knowledge, capabilities, skills, what task can be done by them. Today, employees need to be multitasked. Employee cannot be having only one specialization. And positive work attitude of all people working at all level, all three levels, higher level, middle level, lower level, in the business unit, that is called as the human resource development. So, very first thing, human resource development is the across of increasing knowledge, capabilities, and positive work attitude of all working people at all levels in the business unit. Yes. Training that organization provide to its employees so that they can develop the skills needed to be successful. This is called as human resource development. Now the next, our task is to know the functions of the human resource development. What function organization have to do to develop its employee? That is called as the human resource development. The various function, very first function is given is the performance appraisal. What is the performance appraisal? Performance appraisal is the evaluation of the performance of employees. As business, in business, optimum utilization of resources is very, very essential. That means you should not waste your any of the resource. You need to evaluate performance of employees at regular interval of time. It can be half yearly, it can be quarterly, it can be yearly, so that employee are having fear, you say, or always give the performance and understand. Performance need to be good. Because on the basis of the evaluation, यू हैव टू टेक द डिसीजन फॉर द प्रमोशन, फॉर द डेवलपमेंट ट्रेनिंग, दैट वेदर दे विल बी, इफ द परफॉर्मेंस इज बेटर देन द एक्सपेक्टेशन, देन डेवलपमेंट शुड बी देयर, प्रमोशन शुड बी देयर. इफ परफॉर्मेंस इज नॉट अप टू द मार्क, देन लर्निंग नीड टू बी प्रोवाइडेड. यस, फॉर दैट पर्पज परफॉर्मेंस अप्रेजल बिकम्स वेरी वेरी असेंशियल. द बेस टू अंडरटेक द डिसीजन दैट फॉर द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ एम्प्लॉई, वॉट ट्रेनिंग नीड टू बी प्रोवाइडेड टू होम एट वॉट टाइम, वॉट बिकम्स द बेस, द परफॉर्मेंस अप्रेजल बिकम्स द बेस एंड दैट इज द फर्स्ट फंक्शन ऑफ द ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डेवलपमेंट. वॉट एक्टिविटीज आर कंडक्टेड टू अंडरटेक द ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डेवलपमेंट, द फर्स्ट फंक्शन इज परफॉर्मेंस अप्रेजल. देन द नेक्स्ट वन इज ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ, एज आई टोल्ड यू, दैट वेदर एम्प्लॉय विल बी सेंट फॉर द ट्रेनिंग और एम्प्लॉय विल बी सेंट फॉर द डेवलपमेंट. ट्रेनिंग इज फॉर शॉर्ट पीरियड ऑफ टाइम, इट कैन बी फ्यू आवर्स, इट कैन बी फ्यू वीक्स, बट वेन वी टॉक अबाउट द डेवलपमेंट, डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम्स आर लॉन्ग टर्म, इट कैन बी ऑफ मंथ्स, इट कैन बी ऑफ ईयर्स. सो एज पर द शॉर्टकमिंग्स इन द नॉलेज, स्किल, एटीट्यूड, बिहेवियर ऑफ द एम्प्लॉई विच इज ऑब्जर्व वाइल अंडरटेकिंग परफॉर्मेंस अप्रेजल, द डिसीजन टू सेंड एम्प्लॉय फॉर द ट्रेनिंग और फॉर द डेवलपमेंट इज डिसाइडेड एंड इंडिविजुअल्स आर बींग एक्सपोज टू ट्रेनिंग एंड डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम्स. करियर प्लानिंग, एज इंडिविजुअल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन हैव टू टेक केयर ऑफ इट्स एम्प्लॉयज, हाउ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन वॉन्ट्स ग्रोथ इन द सेम वे, इफ एम्प्लॉयज ऑल्सो नीड करियर ग्रोथ, देन वॉट वेयर दे आर एट टूडे एंड एट वॉट हाइट दे वॉन्ट टू रीच, एंड द प्लैंक बिटवीन दैट टूडे एंड एट वॉट लेवल दे वॉन्ट टू रीच, देयर विल बी अ लैडर, एंड लैडर कैन हैव फ्यू स्टेप्स, लैडर कैन हैव मैनी स्टेप्स, बट टू ग्रो दे हैव टू लर्न, एंड फॉर लर्निंग वॉट एवर रिसोर्सेज टाइम रिक्वायर्ड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन विल प्रोवाइड टूगेदर, लर्नर शुड ऑल्सो बी रेडी टू लर्न एंड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन शुड ऑल्सो प्रोवाइड द रिसोर्सेज टू लर्न. So that comes under the, for the development of the human resource, career planning also is one of the functions of the human resource development. Then next comes the succession planning. As every individual have some limited short span of time, and when the executives, yes, this is about the key position. Succession planning is not for every position. Succession planning is for the key personnel of the organization. Key personnel, that means the manager of the organization. And as manager have taken, existing manager have taken lot of effort to bring the organization to that level. So first, under the succession planning, they search that who are the potential employee who can be put to that position. Shorting out, like in the earlier, yes, the stories you may have heard, king used to have number of sons, yes, and king used to test them that who is the most eligible, yes, successor. And after selecting, after making them go through various difficult tests, yes, king used to decide. And after deciding, selecting the candidate, on his behalf, one used to make him perform the same work what he used to perform, so that is called as the succession planning. Organization, yes, when the key position is going to become vacant at that time, before that, because you know that when you are going to retire, before your retirement, it is also a responsibility to search for the candidate who can take over your position. And that process is called as the, that is for the development, career development of that individual who will be given higher position. So that also comes under the human resource development function. Then next one is employees' participation in management. Employees' participation in management. When employees are allowed, given opportunity to participate in decision making, their motivation, their morale increases. When their morale increases, dedication, they work with dedication. And when they observe, they participate in the decision making, learning also takes place. So the next function of the human resource development is employees' participation in the management decision making process. Then the next is the quality circle. Earlier also in your SY, you have learned that what is a quality improving technique. Yes, quality improvement, techniques of quality improvement, quality circle. Senior employees come together voluntarily. Yes, here the senior employees come together voluntarily. At the end of the week, they take round in the organization, find out what are the small issues in the organization. Four, five employees come together and they discuss the issue and give the suggestion to the management to sort out the issue in the organization. So that also comes under the, because when, though voluntarily, but if these few employees, senior employees are designated at the post of the quality circle group, yes, in that this process, their development takes place. How the issues are sorted out, they learn in this process that how the decision making takes place and how the problems of the organization in day-to-day work can be sorted out. Then next comes the organizational changes and development. As you know that business environment is dynamic. Dynamic, that means it keeps on changing. Change is the only thing which key always certain. Nothing is certain in this earth, on this earth, but changes are very certain. And when changes takes place, why human resource development is required? To get the, develop the adaptability. Yes, change, when changes are taking place, you have to adopt that, you have to develop capacities so that you can survive. Darwin's theory of fittest one. Yes, survival of the fittest one for the to organization to remain fit, to face the changes. Yes, whenever changes takes place, opportunities or challenges can be created. And opportunities are for those who have the strength. For them, whatever changes are there, in that change, they will discover the opportunity. And for that purpose, the organizational changes, organization also have to make changes as per the changes are taking place. For example, nowadays, technology in everywhere, every task, whether it is a promotion, whether it is a product development, whether it is a marketing, you have to use that technology. So organization also have to change. And when organization changes, the development of the organization takes place. So, functions of the human resource development are the performance appraisal, training and development, career planning, succession planning, employees' participation in management, quality circle, and organization changes and development. I hope I am clear. Yes, every one of you have understood. If any doubt is there, please do raise your question. See you in the next lecture. Thank you for your patience hearing. Thanks.